Hi everyone, it's Max Power here. I've got finally some time here to do the review for the Goro piece. So I've had this actually for a little bit now. I posted the video of the box when it came in and the piece sitting on in my collection room. So I just about now had the time to be able to do a full out video on him. I wanted to do an outside video, but two things kind of provided a problem. First, the weather wasn't behaving itself where I live, so it would either be cloudy on the day that I would be able to do something or the time wasn't there. So finally I just said, you know what, I'm just gonna have to do it downstairs. Maybe in the future I might do like a real quick one outside. I'd like to do that for a lot of my other statues, but again, this is a very, very big piece, very heavy piece, and anytime you touch and grab and, you know, you hold something this heavy, there's always a possibility of something breaking, and that's one thing I don't want to do with this one. So a lot of things. The outside videos are pretty hard to do. Like I said, I only reserve those for some pieces that I feel that deserve the outside treatment. This was one, but I just can't seem to coordinate with the weather. So anyway, let's go ahead and get started with this piece. This is a 1/3 scale by Pop Culture Shock. And this was actually around, or it's been, a lot of people have been waiting for this piece for a long time. So I got lucky. I actually put myself on the wait list on this one because I originally had missed it. So I went on the wait list and it hit and I was able to get it. So, and I also got it at the discount price. I think it's 20% off that I got. So yeah, I wanted to make sure I get a one piece since I am a big fan of the Mortal Kombat series in the game. So, and of course the movie. As far as how tall this piece is, you're looking at about 34 inches tall with the hair. I think that's what on their website, the dimensions, they're taking into consideration the hair right over here, so that gives it an extra inch, but he's about 34. So if you're looking for space, 34 is more accurate. I've received this piece like many other people that share their experiences on YouTube with some pieces that were broken. Well, actually one piece that was broken, it was the necklace. So, I got a new replacement for that from Sideshow. They're very nice. They took their time for sure this time, the full 12 days to get that piece for me, but I got it. In addition to my left, well, actually would be his right arm or hand, had a very weak magnet, so I asked them to replace that. Thankfully, they did. The piece that came in was definitely much an improvement, but that's one of the things I do want to share as far as this piece. For as massive as this piece is, and the hands being so heavy and so large, really they could have just put way more stronger magnets, or just really made it one piece. So anyway, that's one of the few things, kind of a quick little thing that I wanted to say about the piece. Let's go ahead and get into the full detail. This is a huge piece, as I said before, so it's very hard to film something like this. That's why, in addition to it being a real nice piece, I wanted to do an outside piece, but outside piece allows me to have better space for filming. So that's not the case. So I'm gonna have to go ahead and take my camera off the tripod, and we'll get into it. All right, we're gonna go ahead and start. Oh, by the way, this is the certificate. Mine's 85 out of 150. So we're gonna go ahead and start with the base. The base is quite, it's got a good weight on it, so it's not super hollow, but there is it's you can grab it with one hand and it won't feel so heavy. The piece itself is super heavy. That I can say. He's very, very heavy. When you put him on the stand, he is super heavy. I don't trust myself holding him for very long that way, so I have to take him apart. So as far as the stand is concerned, a real nice job. Something about Pop Culture Shock and their stands, when they try to get a little bit more creative with their stands, they do an okay job. In this case, the same. There's a few improvements I can say that I would have liked to seen. This the bars here that create the dungeon in the game was a nice touch. The painting on, or the paint here to give it that rust color looks pretty good. I've seen a little bit better, but this is pretty good. No complaints on that one. The stonework is pretty decent as well. So this is where you put the light feature or the adapter on there. This is just a little piece here. So the base part of it is I like it. It's not bad. These lights turn on. I'll have to do that a little later, but they flicker. I like how they flicker the flames. I really like that. All right, base wise, here's where I think they could have improved, honestly. The bones, the props that they put the bones in there, like the victims that he's taking care of, that looks really good. The dirt part of it, I think that's where I kind of feel that they could have done better. Maybe if they put a more grit, or I've seen some bases that have the dirt. I think my Hulk has a little bit of kind of a dusting and stuff on it, and I think that would have gone a long way if that's what this is supposed to be. The colors on it in front of you are kind of like a brown. There is a little bit of red in there, but more brown. So it's, I guess in practicality it might look kind of like a sewage system the way it looks. So if they were going for that, that's what they definitely got. Maybe if they were going for maybe a dirt feel to it, I think they kind of missed it. They put a lot of gloss on it, so it kind of gives it almost like a petrified, fossilized feel to how this is on the base. So I think that would be the only thing that I have to say about that. It's just, doesn't look as realistic, just looks more petrified or fossilized. I don't know. I guess that's the best way I can explain it. So it's got a good amount of gloss, and the pieces on there just look like they're, I don't know, something you would see at a museum that they recreated. So it doesn't look as realistic as I would have liked it to be. All right, now getting to the actual piece itself. Now, this piece is mixed media. Mixed media meaning that it's got, it should have, like, the clothing should be material. So this is kind of a half mixed media, because all of this is sculpted. Where you get to the mixed media, or excuse me, the material part of the mixed media, is the loincloth, the fur, but this is all sculpted, and they put a little bit of mixed media right around the buckles here of the arms. So that's not sculpted right there. That's real material. I don't know if it's real leather. It feels like leather, but it may be just that fake leather. This is real. And then you get to here, that's sculpted. Then we go back to real fur, sculpted. Same thing here, that's real. And this is all sculpted. Alright, these buckles here, so all this is sculpted. Moving up. Okay, we're continuing the mixed media here of the hair, the fake hair. You know, when it comes to mixed media, for me personally, this is just my preference. I know there are a lot of people out there, a lot of collectors, they love the sculpting over the mixed media. Some people just like mixed media. I'm one of those that I really like mixed media. So when I see a description on something that says mixed media, I'm pretty much expecting it to be the entire thing. So in this case, it's kind of like a half mixed media. And if done right, it seems it's okay. In this case, it's done right. You know, I really don't have huge complaints. The sculpting's nice. It does look like fabric, you know, the way they painted it and everything. It's just I kind of feel that in this specific piece with it, I would have liked for them to have gone full all-out mixed media. Like, this should have been fabric and this should have been fabric. I think it would have given it more of a real feel to it, rather than just kind of doing like here, real and then sculpt. So to me, as far as mixed media, it seems kind of like a shortcut. So that I'm a little bit disappointed in. But overall, as far as mixed media itself, how it looks, that even though it's half-half, it looks nice. This is all sculpted. All right, so the sculpt itself is very well done. I mean, if you wanted a representation of Goro and you love the game, this is a really, really nice, well-made representation of Goro. Let's go here into the face. So textures on the skin look real nice. You know, some of the details here, really well done. The muscle definition looks great. And of course, you have the kind of the dragon scales on there. So they did a real good job with that. It goes all the way up to his head. The one thing that I really do enjoy about this statue, and I wish more companies would do, I know Hollywood Collectibles Group does this for the most part, at least the pieces that I've had with them, is that they it's one solid piece, so there's no breakdown of or pieces. Like for something like this, I was actually expecting that there would be a half a torso that you have to put together, but in this case, everything came in one solid piece. I really like that because then you don't have the seams. I wish, as I mentioned, I think earlier in the video, that they would have put stronger magnets. When they don't do stronger magnets, this is the kind of thing that you see. You can fix it a little bit, but you won't be able to fix it. And like I said, this piece is so darn heavy, and for the hands are heavy too, that you will get kind of that dragging, it being heavier than the magnet can hold. Now, it is stable in here, like I won't be able to, with one hand, take it off, but it definitely doesn't connect very well. And I've seen videos of other people complaining about PCS, and they seem to do that quite often on their pieces where their seams don't fit together very well for the hands. So something like this, being that it was such an expensive piece, it would have been much better if they would have just gone that extra mile and just made it just one piece with the hands including. Because you run into this kind of problem where the magnets might not be strong enough. So as you can see right there, obviously you won't be jiggling this when he's just being displayed, but the big pieces or the ones that are kind of fighting gravity here, you're going to have to deal with this. This is the hand that came very with the weak net magnet, which is his right back arm. And this is the piece that it replaced right here. This one I follow Rad Titan. Those guys are fantastic. They had like a little workaround if you had something. If you had a weak magnet, so I tried to do that. They suggested to scrape the paint here to see if we can make a stronger connection. As you can see, I did that. By the way, if you're looking for some real good videos and informative information, those guys are really you can follow their channel. They're just really great. But anyway, so I tried that and it just didn't work. So I have to ask Sideshow to replace that. Just to give you an idea, because they didn't ask me that I had to break the piece, but just right there you can see the new piece, just how easy it came off. But this is the piece that it came with originally, the one that I scraped to make sure they had better connection. And I'm going to zoom in here. As you can see, all I'm doing is just barely touching it, and it just comes off. I mean, on something like this, I mean, you can see it's just barely just jiggling in there. And if I were just to barely tip it, it would come off. So really just a terrible way. Like I said, they really would have been able to fix a lot of these problems if they would have just gone that extra mile and just sculpted the arms in one piece. So this is the replacement piece. Definitely much better. Still not super strong, but it won't
I don't have to just barely touch it and it'll fall off. But it just makes me wonder about something like this. Can I glue it? Will it obviously it'll devalue, I think, the piece, but would you rather glue these pieces on and it sit there and it doesn't fall off, or by mistake you tip it and the arm falls off? So I don't know. That's one of the things I said, that if they don't replace that piece, I'm just gonna glue it. Forget it. Forget the value. I'm just gonna glue it. I'd rather have this piece in one whole piece than, have one arm missing or broken, and then I have to fix the arm. So same thing here. Some of these are magnets, not super strong. If I really wanted to, I can just whoop. There we go. So. And see how it kind of hangs there. Just not very good on that part. And those arms, like I said, are really heavy. This is probably the strongest magnet right here. This one's really kind of in there, although it jiggles a little bit. Or maybe it's this one. I think this one's the strongest. But anyway, so all of them not super strong, except maybe this one. My replacement is better. And the other piece that came broken was my necklace. A lot of people had their necklace broken. Mine wasn't so severe. I had here's my other necklace. This is the one that they replaced. This one had the teeth that were broken on this one. So on this side, so I'm gonna set it down here. So on this side here, it's got spikes, and there should be spikes over here, and that's what broke. Other people's have been broken in pieces, so I was lucky, but I still asked for a replacement, and they gave it to me. These are the only accessory that Goro comes with, and it's okay. I don't know what to expect it. They advertised as being kind of a neat jewel, and it's okay. It's nothing really that unique or special. It kind of almost feels a little, it's plastic, so I don't know. I guess I was expecting a little bit more on this one, but it does the job. It is an accessory, so no big deal. The other piece that comes off is the hair piece. Going back to the mixed media, like I said before, when they do a half thing, I think it's a little bit, more of a time-saving thing than it is. They don't want to do the whole thing. And this is another thing that I really not that fond of, is the fact that they went sculpt and then they went real. If you're with a statue over $1,000, my opinion, my thoughts are, let's just go all out, man. Make this hair. Just put hair here and make the whole thing. Don't cut corners and do something like this. It looks okay, but from far away. But then you come here, you have this real nice mixed media, and then you're, oh, okay. So that's personal, at least for me. Okay, let's go back to the back. It's interesting that when I took this out, the decisions that they make, obviously with the hands, if it's one solid piece. Now I kind of understand when the packaging thing, and they try to save, to make it so it doesn't break in packaging and things like that. But I'm thinking as far as the hands, if it was maybe a smaller hand, or maybe it was kind of like a with long fingers. I think that would have a little bit more of a possibility in breaking during shipment. But here you have a solid arm, and I'm still baffled as far as why it's a magnet piece when it could have been just one solid piece. I think it would have been okay being that way. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and lift this up. I think someone had asked, and this is what you see from underneath. So this is sculpted here, and then I I think they did the same thing here. It's just kind of a sculpted piece. Another interesting thing that I found was that the fabric, the mixed media here, they went with a real nice kind of a thick leather, or maybe not leather, but definitely leather looking and feel. And then for this piece, the loincloth, it looks nice. It's just, if it's very, what's the word? Just doesn't feel very heavy at all. It's almost like super, super, super thin. So it almost feels like plastic. So I think they could have maybe gone with a little heavier, kind of like this material on the loincloth, but it looks good from far away. It's just very super, super thin. I mean, it's like, all right. The eyes on this, they're pretty good. From far away, they're pretty good. I don't have much to complain. I guess it could have been done better. You know, I'm a person that collects the big stuff, the 1/3 scale. And so, you know, when you get pieces from like ECC, Elite Creatures Collectible, and you're paying over $1,000 for a piece or something like that, I think I've grown to some bigger expectations. And this piece wasn't, it was a little bit pricey as far as, you know, most people that order this. So definitely, you know, over $1,000 on this, on a piece like this. Of course, I got a discount on that, so I never pay full price for something like this. But, you know, anything that I believe is over $1,000, you're expecting, you know, more quality, better materials. And for something like this that retails at over $1,000, I think they wanted like $1,200 or something like that. Yeah, I expected translucent resin. You know, if this would have had the translucent resin treatment, it would have really been, I think, in my opinion, a much more life-looking than what we have with the traditional resin on a piece, especially this big. So, and of course, you know, acrylic eyes or glass eyes or whatever they're calling it nowadays, that would have been an extra touch. So, and then the true media, mixed media, rather than something like this. But that's, again, that's just me. I when I get it, see something that's up in that price range, my expectations go up a little bit more. One thing to say too, as far as unboxing this piece, that these belt buckles are magnets, actually. Another weird, I think, choice when it comes to packaging, along with the hands. So, you know, I guess these could have been sculpted. Maybe there was fear that the buckles would break. Maybe that's the case. But if you give them enough space in the box, I don't think that would have been a problem. So that was super weird, I thought. You know, why have these extra little things that you could lose or they could break, you know, by themselves? Luckily, they are color-coded. So if, you know, at first I was like, how do you put all this stuff together? But they are color-coded and they're also labeled. So you just have to figure out the labeling. As you can see, CR1. So that's labeled CR1. They're color-coded as well. And that's how you know. This will say probably CR2, yep, on there. On this side, you're gonna find, you know, the red color here, CL1. So they're in there, but I don't think it was something that needed to be done that way. It could have just been sculpted and just left that way. Okay, so I'm going to pull back a little bit here so you guys can see kind of like how it looks all together. Again, big piece at 35, well, 34 realistically, but 35 with the hair. So you can see kind of the whole package here, what it looks like. While it does have its shortcomings, I'm really happy with this piece. Again, I'm a Mortal Kombat fan, so if I wanted to have a character or a statue that represents the game, at least for me, it would always be Goro and Reptile, those which I also have, but Goro primarily because he was the boss on the first game. And then later on, obviously this is from the previous game, the Mortal Kombat 10. But overall, happy with this piece. Glad I got it at a discounted price. Glad I actually got it because I didn't buy it originally and I put myself on the wait list and it hit. So I'm very happy with that. So I think it's a very nice representation of Goro and Mortal Kombat franchise. All right, let me see if I can turn on the lights here for you real quick. I didn't plug it in. That's another thing that I was a little disappointed is the cord is super short on this. So let me see if I can connect it here. So I didn't want to have it connected when I was spinning him because then it would disconnect. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the button here. So there's like a little, it's not a toggle switch, but just a little press button here. Okay. All right, so here are the flickering lights. Anybody that had that bought the gizmo from ECC, that's probably what they should have done. They added like a light feature on the torch on that gizmo, and they didn't make it flicker, which was a real disappointment considering, you know, that they stay true to their prototypes. I think their prototype flickered, but that would have been an extra touch. In this case, it looks real nice. My light, for whatever reason, on this side seems to be a little bit more finicky, so it sometimes if I move it a little bit it turns off, so I just have to adjust it some. So, and they too just kind of come in, they're not I'm going to do this one because that one, if I take it off then it might be difficult to turn it back on, but these ones just come connection. Here's the connection right there. So you just plug it in there. Oops, let's see if I can get this here. Yeah. There we go. Yep, having a hard time connecting it back here. Here we go. All right, it's in. So same thing here, just that disconnects or take off. All right, I think I've said my piece with this statue. I don't think there's anything I left. Like I said, it's a super heavy piece. I can't tell you the weight. The base, I guess, hollow, but it feels solid, so no big deal. The piece itself being one solid piece, super heavy. The hands could have been better, had better magnets for sure. Would have loved to have full mixed media rather than the half sculpt and half material, especially on this part. You know, I would have, this is all fine, but this piece, you know, kind of takes it away from the realism of the character when you have this, and then it goes to his full mixed media. So its accessories are okay. No, you know, they're just, they feel just a little bit, I think it maybe could have been a little better on the accessories, but no big deal. And overall, the sculpt is real nice. I always thought this was kind of weird, just the sculpt in here. I don't remember how he looks in the game, but it could be because he's kind of stooping, so he's crunching his stomach and the way his body is. But everything is, I think it's real nice. They really did a good job. Translucent resin would have put this over the top for sure, in my opinion. It would have looked so much more realistic, but as it is, he is great. Real nice detail on the face. They capture his face, everything there really well. I guess the one mention I do have is that people that had gotten this piece, they mentioned some kind of white powder or mold. I didn't have too much of that. I did have it, and I could, when I opened the box, I could tell that some of the bags or the bag that he came with had some moisture, or you could tell there was some water residue in there, and perhaps that's where you got that mold. But I didn't have that much of it on my piece. So it wasn't fully covered in that. All right, guys, if you have any comments or any questions, you know, they're always welcome on my channel. Appreciate you guys watching. Again, if you want to see some real nice stuff, some real informative, take a look at Rad Titan's channel. They're fantastic as far as information, and they really take their time to give you a detailed review of these collectibles. So thank you again for joining me, and I will see you soon. Bye.